Hallo zusammen, I'm your vlog Dave. Yes, it's definitely true. The German language can be quite complicated, and quite often, to be honest. But despite of that, there are also some rather simple, basic grammar rules that are easy to understand. You just have to know about their existence, pretty much. Rule number one. A very simple and basic one. All German nouns are spelled with a capital letter. German nouns are called das Substantiv Singular, die Substantive Plural. And people might also refer to them as das Nomen Singular, die Nomen Plural. This spelling is actually a major difference to the English language. It doesn't matter if it's the first, the last, or a word in the middle of a sentence. German Substantive are always spelled with a capital letter. Der Hund meiner Nachbarn ist süß. This sentence contains two Substantive. Der Hund Singular, die Hunde Plural. And der Nachbar Singular, die Nachbarn Plural. And this actually leads us to the second simple German grammar rule. All German nouns in plural feature the article die. As you might know already, there are three basic grammatical genders in German. And each of these three genders, das Geschlecht Singular, die Geschlechter Plural, relates to a particular article. Masculine nouns in Singular are related to the article der. Feminine nouns in Singular are related to the article die. And neuter nouns in Singular are related to the article das. However, there is one thing that counts for all of them equally. When you either have a masculine, a feminine, or a neuter noun, and you'd want to use the respective plural forms, you'd always use the plural article die. Der Hund Singular, die Hunde Plural. Die Uhr Singular, die Uhren Plural. Das Auto Singular, die Autos Plural. As you can see, the plural forms Hunde, Uhren and Autos all feature the plural article die. Keep in mind though that we're talking about the basic forms of those nouns, meaning the nominative case, which already implies that there are some other forms for other grammatical cases, because articles can be inflected. You can learn more about both the grammatical cases and a different set of articles relating to them in my German lesson about just that. Just click the thumbnail at the end of this video. So talking about the article die, as a singular article that is. This is an indicator for feminine nouns in singular, and this leads to rule number three. German nouns that end in the suffix -ung are feminine nouns.
Hint, hint.
Here are a few examples. Die Gleichung, the equation. Die Bestattung, the funeral or burial. Die Genesung, the recovery. Many recurring and fixed endings of German words, called suffixes, das Suffix Singular, die Suffixe Plural, are linked to one out of the three respective aforementioned grammatical genders. I've also made individual lessons for each article and which suffixes they relate to, so feel free to check out those videos too. Number 4. It's usually time before place in German sentences. In German sentences, the rule of thumb is usually time, manner, place. When, how, where. Ich bin gleich mit dem Paket da. Gleich is a temporal adverb. It means in a moment. And da means there. It's a local adverb. Time, gleich, before place. Da. It's the other way around in English sentences, with the exception of sentences that begin with the temporal information that's followed by an information about a place. In general, the German word order is partially flexible. For instance, you could put the temporal information at the beginning of a sentence as well. Gleich bin ich mit dem Paket da. So here, the focus, the perspective is a bit different, yet it's still time before place. Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a like and to share it with other people. And if you want to support this channel even more, check out my Patreon page. A little tip per video can make a difference and help me a lot. Also feel free to follow me on social media. I'm your Vlog Dave. Tschüss und bis zum nächsten Mal.